Hello YouTube. Okay, so my name is Bear and I'll be doing a tutorial for you guys, and this is my first tutorial, so let's hope I don't do too bad. So I'm gonna teach you how to make like almost anything react to audio. Let me just get you guys a little example right here. So, as you can see, these spikes, or whatever, they are reacting to the audio. So yeah, I wanna teach you guys that. And to do this, you need After Effects by Adobe. This works with CS5 and... I don't know about CS4, but... yeah, probably works there as well. And CS6 as well. Okay, so first we need some pictures. Let me just grab something right here. Okay. There, and then we need a song. Guess I could take this one. Yeah. Okay, so first make a new composition, of course. Just gonna make like 3 minutes and 1080. Background color doesn't really matter. Let me just call this audio react. Okay, so then you drag in your pictures, yeah, and song, and let me just scale this up. Oh, nice. Okay, so yeah, to get up scale, just press S on your keyboard and you'll get scale. So then we need to make this react to the audio, you know, make it go like this, change scale after the audio. So to do this, you just right click on your audio layer and you hold over keyframe assistant, and then you press convert to audio keyframes, and then it will make this layer right here. So just hit E on that and delete left and right channel. And you need to delete left and right channel because I told you so. Then you open both channels and you see slider right here. You see all these keyframes. It's a lot. And then you just hold Alt and you left click on this little watch or clock or whatever it is. And you'd get this. Then you open the graph editor and you type in linear. This sign, I don't know what's it called. Then you type in value, comma, then you find the lowest keyframe, or one of the lowest, I guess. And let's go with 5 or 10. Yeah, 10. Okay, so that's the minimum or lowest value keyframe. Then you find maximum or something around it. So I'll just go with 55, I guess. Yeah, 55. Okay. And then you need to type in two more numbers, and let's just type like 500. So that means that 5 is the minimum scale and 100 is the maximum scale. So when the video is at like 15 seconds and it's like, let's say, yeah, that was a bad example, but when the song is at keyframe which is 10, then the scale would go down to 5. And when it's at a keyframe that is valued 55, then the scale would go up to 100%. So let's just find something here. 25, I guess. That would be the minimum scale, and 35 could be the maximum. Then close it with this. And then, on the picture you want to make reacted audio, just hold Alt and left click that little watch again. You drag this rope thing, or whatever it's called, over to the slider, and then drop it. And you're done, basically. So now it reacts to the audio. Now I maybe didn't take the best song to do this song for, but yeah, it'll do. Okay, so let's just preview that real quick. Oh yeah, and if anyone of you know what this song is called, I would appreciate it if you could tell me in the comment section, because I've been looking everywhere for this song, but I can't find the name. It's impossible. Okay, so let's preview that. Yeah, yeah. We set it off right, baby. How we do it? They call me cliche. How we rolling? I think I'm the best. Yes. I think I'm the best. Yes. I think I'm the best. What's it take to impress? You could just admit it. Niggas be haters, though. Cliche is coming, huh? Whoa, cliche is coming. Okay, so that works. And you can actually make anything react to the audio. So let me just give you an example and make a new audio keyframe layer. And you need to change the name of this if you... Let's just put a 2 behind. Yeah. And just do the same thing. Delete left and right channel. Open both channel. And let's find an effect. How about... channel blur, that's really cool. Okay, so make a new layer. Oh yeah, new layer there, and adjustment layer, I guess we can roll with that. Or no, let's make something cooler. Let's take a flare, make it glow or something, I guess. This flare, I guess? Yeah, that's cool. Okay, so just drag that in there and drop it here. Damn it. Okay, so scale that and make it screen. Oh yeah, we need a white background. There we go. Okay, so I guess we can scale it up a bit more. Yeah, whatever. Actually, new solid, call it something like gray. Okay, that's better. Okay, so now we have done that. Let's position it correctly real quick. There we go. And now we want this to like glow after the audio. So let me just copy it and see here. On this one, just type in that code, Alt left click on that, type in the code, linear value something like 260 060, and 0 100. So what that does is I'm going to link the opacity to the slider, so when the keyframe is at 0, the opacity would be at 0, and when the keyframe is at 60, the opacity would be 100. So that would create this blink strobe thing effect. So let's just alt left click and drag that over to the audio layer or audio amplitude. So that works. Okay. Let me just preview that for you. But it's working. So yeah, now you know that. So thank you guys for watching, and please leave a comment or drop a like, and if it's something you feel like I need to explain a bit more, or if you have any questions for me, just type it in the comment section and I'll probably answer you. Anyways, thank you for watching. Peace.